All right, phenomenal hand. I'm actually just going to preserve my life total by playing Godless Shrine tapped on turn one. Then turn two, I can go Thoughtseize and either play this tapped, or if it's like an emergency situation, I can play it untapped and Thoughtseize again. But either way, I'm going to save the two life from my turn one shrine coming in tapped. The only way it could come back to bite me is if he keeps like a one lander with Elvish Mystic or something like that, but that's obscure enough that I definitely don't want to spend two life to play around it. All right, here we go. I also got to draw another green land for the Glucranos, but that's a perfect curve topper for this type of matchup. All right. Forest, mountain, Tusker, Tusker, ooze, Gorklan. I think I want to take either the Xenagos or the Gorklan. Probably the Gorklan, so that I can just block with Glucranos the turn that I play it. Yeah, that seems like the right move. So this turn will be Forest Tusker, and I'll probably go Abrupt Decay Thoughtseize. Drew a temple. That's fine. So yeah, take away the Xenagos, and then the Hero's Downfall will be for the Scavenging Ooze. And I just gotta hope to hit that second green mana before too many bad things happen to me. Yeah, it's pretty realistic for me to lose this game just by drawing like three or four cards in a row that I can't cast with what I have in play. But drawing a land would be great, drawing more removal would be great, drawing Sylvan Caryatid would be great. Still in my deck that I can't cast is 3 6 drops. 5/5 drops, one more Pelucranos, three more Coursers. I guess that's not a very high portion of my deck, which is nice. And even something like Reid the Bones would be great. That would help me hit my land drops and just guarantee a win if I can survive. Let's hope he scries to the bottom here. Well, thinking about it is a good sign. Might just be another weenie creature or something. Just to recap, my opponent's hand is Mountain, Colonian Tusker, Scavenging Ooze, and whatever he drew for this turn. So he's going to attack me, I'm going to Abrupt Decay, and he's going to play another Tusker. Then if I draw green mana, I'll be in great shape. Otherwise, I'll have to sit back on Hero's downfall. Top. Okay. It's a little scary. Alright, no blocks. I broke the K. I'm going to abrupt decay this now. I'd rather have more creatures in the graveyard because I have scavenging uses of my own. Maybe that's actually not a good play. It's more likely that he has another scavenging use than that I draw one. No locks. Abrupt decay. Corsair. Ooh, this could get ugly. Perfect. It's interesting. Given the war chant, I may actually want to top this here. So my opponent's hand is Gruul Warchant and one unknown card. Do I want to try to race? I guess I just want the maximum chance of being able to play land off the top. Oh, and I get my wish. Scavenging Ooze is really good here. My opponent has four creatures already in the graveyard, although I guess I probably just want to get the Elspeth in play as quickly as possible. So as strange as it seems, I'm going to scry this to the bottom. And that's no guarantee that I'll be able to play Elspeth next turn, but I will get to play Elspeth at some point in this game, which is going to be big. I'm going to employ my strategy of just always blocking. And that's fine. It's better than losing my Elspeth to it. Alright, so last card in my opponent's hand is Gruul Warchant, which means Polukranos won't get me out of trouble here, but Elspeth hopefully will. So I'm going down to 6 here, and I'll be dead to a Rampager on my turn, but I will be pretty safe if I can fade one draw step. Come on. It's fine. Ooh, Boonseder, interesting. Yeah, I think the Elspeth's going to be good enough here. Especially with the Doomblade and the monstrosity available to me. Thank you. Well, I don't think that's a very good play. I guess it's not the worst, just trading a Tusker for three soldiers. It's fine. Scavenging is my top card. So, as long as I can survive a turn or two, I'm going to pull out of range pretty quickly here. Let's see this draw step, and then I'll consider the option of killing the courser inside the draw step. So what exactly do I want to happen here? I'm gonna Doomblade whatever he puts the Boonsader on, then I can kill the Boonsader with Monstrosity, and he'll just have a clean board with an Elvish Mystic on top of his library. All right, so pretty close match, but narrowly win, and I'll be back for round three.